In this video, I'm going to show you how to make some Illustrator art using this style where we use the pen tool to make kind of these rhythmic lines. All right, let's get started. So I started something here off camera, and the first thing that you should do when you're going to make one of these is to find a photograph that you want to trace. So let me turn off everything I have so far and show you my photo. So I took this into Photoshop. You could also do this in Illustrator. And I just drew some lines to just block off the basic shapes that are in this red panda. So that would be your first step, is to find your photo and to just outline some of the basic color blocks that are in the photo that you're gonna do. Now on this one, I'm only gonna do half of it and then flip it to the other side, like do a mirror image to make the other half. So that's something that you can do if you're doing something that's symmetrical. It might save you a little bit of time if you just do half of it and then flip it over. So after you open your photo in Photoshop and make the outlines around it, you can bring it into Illustrator, or you could even just draw these lines in Illustrator. It doesn't have to be in Photoshop. So the next thing that you're gonna do is make another layer that has a black background. That way you can turn on and off your template layer to see what you have, and I'll show you what I have so far, what I've done off camera. This is what I have so far. So I'm going to show you how to make these lines, and you're going to use the pen tool to make the lines, and the other tool that you're going to use is the blend tool. Looks like this. So basically for the lines, you're going to, I'll just do one off to the side here. You're going to click once with the pen tool, and then click again, but before you let go, pull out a handle so that you get kind of a curve like this. And then when you're done drawing the line, it's gonna continue to wanna draw it. Just click on the selection tool to end it. And you're gonna wanna go over here and make the stroke, let's make the stroke white and make it no fill. The panels that you should have open are stroke and color. Those are gonna be the main things that you're gonna use for this. So I'm gonna bump up the stroke to be maybe about 4 points. And then the most important part is down here where it says profile. You're gonna wanna click on that and choose this right here, this kind of tapered end shape. If you don't have these options when you're opening your stroke panel, just click on the side and there'll be a thing that says show options, and then you can get the full window. All right, so you can see, let me click off of that and zoom in a little bit. You can see I have this kind of curved line that has tapered ends to it. And the way you wanna do these is to do them in sections. So you'll notice when I click on mine, you can see I have just these little sections done. You don't wanna do too many at once. It's easier and more manageable if you just do them in groups. So let's say I have this one line here and I want it to blend down here. So you could change the size like that. And you're gonna select both of those. And then you're going to go over here to the blend tool and double click on it. And you wanna click on specified steps. The number of steps that you have, you're gonna probably go back and forth and change this. I'm gonna start off with 10, and I have the orientation on this align to path type of thing, and then say okay. And then what it does, you'll see that it gives you this different kind of cursor that has the blend. You're going to click on one of the lines and then click on the other, and you can see it gave me a bunch of lines in between. Now let's say I want those closer together. I can double click on this again, and I can still change the amount of lines that it's given me. So that's editable. You can go back and forth, change that as many times as you want until the lines are spaced out the way you want. The other cool thing is you can take your direct selection tool and you can edit this, whoops, click off of it and then click on your first line. You can edit it and it will still keep blending the lines according to how you change those first two lines. So basically what's determining it is the first and last line that you drew. So if you do something and you want to edit it, you can keep editing it by moving those points, endpoints on your first and last path around. All right, so once you've practiced with the line blending, you can go ahead and start working on your photo. So notice how I have my photo template on another layer and I have it locked so that I don't accidentally select it. And I've already started, you know, some of my lines on this layer here. So make a new layer for your line art. And I'll go ahead and continue some of the stuff that I started just so that you can see again how it's done. I get my pen tool and I'm pick up here where I left off on this last section and give it kind of a curve like this. And then click on my direct selection tool to get out of the pen editing mode. And then go over here to stroke. And maybe I'll make it, I think, maybe 3 points. And then give it this profile with this tapered end here so that it looks like that. And then I'm going to move this one out of the way a little bit. And I think I'll lower the stroke just a little bit to 2 points. And then I want to make another line, maybe somewhere down here. You don't want to make the lines too far apart or it starts really getting strange on you. So I'm going to copy that line and rotate it a little bit, stretch it out to be bigger. Something like that's probably good. All right, then I'm going to click on this line and my first line that I drew. And I'm going to click on the blend tool and then click once on the top line, once on the bottom. And there we go. So let's turn off the template for a minute and you can see this new grouping of lines. And once again, remember you can move these around. It's in a group. So if you want to reposition it, you can. If you want to change the number of lines, you would just double click this and change the number of lines. All right. So I'm not going to do all of those on camera because it's just, repeating over and over again the same process. So once you have the whole thing filled out, I will restart the video after I do that and show you how you can finish this up. All right, so I have most of the left half of my red panda here with the line work done in it. So I'm going to turn off the photo template so you can see how that's looking. So it still needs a little bit of edits, and there's a few things I want to point out to you that kind of help these things look better. I went ahead and just drew my eye. I'm not using all these little lines to do the eye. And then same with the nose. I just used the pen tool to draw these shapes for the eye and for the nose. And then you can see I also put just kind of an outline around the tongue to give it like a rounder edge. And then same with the whole outside outline of the panda. I gave that a thicker line as well. To kind of close off some of those edges, maybe I'll put another one right along the bottom. Whoop! If you do this, you want to make sure you don't connect to one of your lines like I just did. So I'm going to do Control Z and click off of that. I don't want to attach my point to one of those lines. So make sure you're clicking away from the edge that you have there of one of these line groups. So I'm going to go to, and also see how that's trying to close off onto that last line. I don't want that. So make sure you don't have that little symbol under your pen tool. I'm going to click there and then click the selection tool to get off of that. Put it in the uniform profile or the width profile here. And then I'm going to bump up the size or the weight of the stroke. All right, that probably looks okay. Now, remember you can edit this stuff still. So if there's things that you don't like I'm not super crazy about that. Maybe I want to lower this, I can lower it. But notice how when I do lower it, it still leaves this gap right here. So it's kind of a compromise as far as that goes. But I do think it looks better like that. And now I want to show you how to reflect it. So I have this left half done over here on this layer. I want to duplicate that and flip it the other way. So I'm going to get my selection tool, click on this, and I'm going to go ahead and group it, Control G, so that I have all my lines in one selection, and then click on it. And then if you go over here behind the rotate tool, you'll see a reflect tool. So you can double click on that and choose vertical. Reflect, vertical, and then choose copy. All All right, so it gave me another copy of it, and now I can click on it and slide it over. Doesn't want to let me select it. There we go. Slide it over and position it so that it's not overlapping too much. So when you first do a mirror reflection of your two halves, if you're doing one of these symmetrical kind, you'll see that they might not fit together perfectly. So I want to show you how you can correct it to fit together a little bit better. All right, so I'm going to zoom in here. Now remember, we grouped this, so I'm going to do Control Shift G to ungroup it. Same with this other side, Control Shift G. And then you can click on the parts that aren't connecting together. Just click on those and you can just kind of pull them out and just adjust them manually until they close up any gaps. Something like about this. And then when you have something where you've drawn a path, like maybe up here, you can just get your direct selection tool and move things so that they line up a little bit better. Like that. And you can even use the pen tool to just kind of fill in some of the areas that weren't made properly by the lines. So I'm going to kind of make this little V shape here. All right, so there you have it. There's the final piece. Don't forget, if you need to move anything around, you can always get your direct selection tool and go back in and change any of these lines. Like this one looks a little too thick. You can still change how thick and thin their lines are. You can move their direction. So there's a lot of editing that you can still do after the fact.